Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. Today we'll do the second part of the linear equations problems that we started in the previous video. We did problems 1 through 15 in the previous video, dealing with the notion of linear equations. Linear equations, and today we'll do the second part in the series, beginning with problem number 16, and I have about 23 of them, so 16 through 23. Let's begin. Number one. These are the sort of linear equations that you have to be able to solve. These are the sort of linear equations that you are likely to encounter in any of these tests, whether you're preparing for GRE or GMAT or TEES or HESES or SAT or ACT. You have to be able to solve simple linear equations. That's exactly what they are. They are very simple linear, very simple, very straightforward linear equations. You just have to be able to solve them quickly. Here we go. First one. We are told 7x minus 2 over 11 minus 4 minus 5x over 7 equals 6. As we can clearly see, and as we had done in the first 15 problems, as we can see here, these terms do not have the same denominators. They do not have a common denominator. We need a common denominator here. We have 11, we have a 7, we have a 1. The common denominator, or to be more precise, the least common multiplier, LCM here, would be simply 77, because this is a prime number, this is a prime number, so we simply have to multiply the two. 77 is the least common multiplier. We could use 770, or we can use 77 billion, but that will just create more work. It will not going to add anything to our information. We want the least number possible, which is a multiple of both 7 and 11. And the smallest number that we can find, which happens to be a multiple of both 7 and 11, is 77, least common multiplier. So how do we convert this into 77? It's very simple. Take this quantity and multiply it by 7 over 7. We haven't changed anything. We have simply multiplied by 1. 7 over 7 is 1. So we haven't changed this value. Here we have a 7. We want 77. So take the second term and multiply it by 11 over 11. There we go. And that happens to equal to 6. We don't want 1 at the bottom. We want 77 at the bottom. So there we go. Simply multiplied by 77 over 77. There we go. That's it. We're done. So now we simply have to take care of it. 7 times 7 is 49x. 7 times negative 2 is negative 14. Make sure this is, pay attention here, this is a negative here. Negative 11 times 4 is going to be negative 44. And again, here we have a negative and here we have a negative. This negative and that negative will make it a positive. Positive 11 times 5 is 55. And that's all it is. It's a matter of paying attention. That's all there is. And this is 7 times 77. We'll leave it like this, unless we actually have to do that, because a lot of the times if you leave it like this, by the time you get to the last step, you can reduce it without having to multiply out the two numbers. We have seen that many times. We'll multiply them if we have to. So here we have 49x and a 55x. 55x plus 50x, listen carefully, 55 plus 50 would have been exactly 105. We don't have 50, we have 49, so it's going to be 104x. And here we have 14 and 44, so that's 58. Minus 58 equals, now as you can see, in order for us to get rid of this 58, we're going to have to bring that 58 over there. In other words, we're going to have to add 58 to this quantity, which means we have no choice but to figure out what this quantity is. 6 times 77 is very straightforward, very simple. We know 6 times 7, 6 sevens are 42. We know our 6 tables. 6 sevens are 42. Therefore, 6 times 70 is just going to be 420. And again, 6 sevens are 42. Looks to me that it's going to be 462. Now bring 58 to the other side. It's going to drop out and we'll end up with 2, carry 1, 12. Did I make a mistake? It's not a 2, did I? I made a mistake, didn't I? See, that's why it's very important to pay attention. It's 0, carry 1, we're going to be 12, carry 1, and 520 equals 104x. There you go. Well, that's pretty straightforward. If 104x equals 520, then x must be 5, because 100 times 5 is 500, and 4 times 5 is 20. 4 5s are 20, and 5 4s are 20. 5 4s are 20, and 5 100s are 500. So x equals 5. That's it. We're done. We're going to put it back in here, quickly verify our work, make sure our answer is correct. Always a good idea to verify it. 7 times x, which we're claiming to be 5, minus 2 over 11, minus 4 minus 5x. X is, we're claiming that it is 5 over 7. Let's see what that works out, shall we? Let's have a demarcation here. Let's have a demarcation here. So here we go. 7 times 5 is 35. 35 minus 2 is 33. 33 over 11. 33 over 11 minus 5 times 5 is 25. 4 minus 25 is going to be negative 21. Negative 21 over 7, which is going to be negative 3. So we have 3 minus a negative 3. 3 minus a negative 3 is positive 6, which is exactly what we were told here. It checks out. It is exactly 6, which means our answer is correct. Our answer is correct. I don't have the list of my words here, so I cannot tell you when we learned the word demarcate. Perhaps if I remember it, I'll tell you in the next video. I'm going to put it at the very bottom so that I don't end up erasing it inadvertently. We'll learn it in the next video, the day when we learn the word demarcate in our vocabulary lessons. As I said, I don't have the list right now. Lesson number 17. Number 17. As I have told you before many times, it's not a bad idea, it does not hurt for you to stop the video, pause the video, and do the problem yourself first. As soon as I write the problem on the blackboard, pause the video without mine having to remind you. Do you understand? Without my having to remind you. Just pause the video instinctively. I shouldn't be doing this thing because I really don't know how to spell the word. Instinctively comes from the word instinct, of course. You do it by instinct. As soon as I put the problem on the blackboard, pause the video. How do I want you to pause the video? The verb is instinctively. Instinct is the noun, instinctive is the adjective, and instinctively would be the adverb. Number 17. 2x plus 4 over 3, we are told, plus x minus 2 over 5, we are told, equals 7. So this time we're going to pick up a little bit speed here. There is no reason for us to explain every baby step in excruciating detail, so I'm going to go a little bit faster. We have a 3 and a 5, common denominator is going to be 15. In order for us to make this denominator 15 here, we need to multiply the first quantity by 5 over 5. Make sure you put a parenthesis here so that you can keep it separate visually. Here we need to multiply it by 3 over 3. Again, put a parenthesis around it right away so that you remember that this 3 is to be multiplied by not only x but also the negative 2. And again, here we want 15 over 15. Well, now we have a denominator of 15. We are home free. The rest is downhill. So let's get going. So we're going to have 5 times 2x is going to be 10x. This is where you have to pay attention, because this is where you're likely to make a careless mistake. 3 times x is 3x. 3 times negative 2 is 6. And this is where I also have to pay attention, because if I keep yapping too much, I might make a mistake. Minus 13, something, I don't like it, I think something has gone wrong already. Minus 6, it's not minus 13, I don't know where the hell I get minus 13. 20 minus 6 is 14, and it's positive 14, what the hell? See, this is why you have to pay attention, do you understand? subtract 14 from both sides, subtract 14 from both sides. I'm going to subtract 14 from here, and I'm going to subtract 14 from here. But what, because it's 14, which happens to be a multiple of 7, watch what happens. Because it's 14 and happens to be a multiple of 7, I'm going to subtract 14 from here in this form. 14 is going to go away. Here we end up with 13x equals 15 sevens, listen carefully, 15 seven minus 2 sevens. So if you have 15 seven and if you take away 2 sevens, you're left with 13 sevens. 13 sevens. Divide both sides by 13, 13 goes away, and x equals 7. X equals 7. Let's verify it. Times x, which we are claiming to be 7, plus 4 over 3, plus x minus 2, 7 minus 2 over 5. Let's see what this gives us. 2 times 7 is 14, 14 plus 4 is 18, 18 divided by 3 is 6, plus 7 minus 5 is 7 minus 2 is 5, 5 divided by 5 is 1. 6 plus 1, which is a 7, which is exactly what we are claiming, what we were given. So that tells us that our answer is indeed correct. Number 18. Number 18. Again, pause the video right away. X plus 3 over 4 plus 3x minus 2 over 4, it cannot be over 4 both times, it was 14 here, equals 3. Now as you can see, I wasn't paying too much attention, I didn't leave enough space here. Typically I leave enough space here and here so that we can do our multiples that we have to multiply, that we have to put there. So what is going to be the least common multiplier? Here you could use 14 times 4, you could use 14 times 4 as our multiplier, as a common denominator, and make a common denominator 14 times 4, in which case we're going to have to multiply this quantity by 4 over 4, and this quantity by 14 over 4, and this quantity by 4 times 14. You could do that, but that is not how one does it. That is not an efficient way, that is not the proper way. The proper way, the efficient way, the correct way, the academic way, is to find not just any old multiplier, but the least common multiplier. We do want a common multiplier, we do want denominator to be the same, we do want the common denominator, we do want the denominator to be the same, but it has to be the least possible multiplier of all the denominators that are given to us here. The denominators that are given to us here are 14, 4, and 1. The least common multiplier of these three quantities is going to be, this is how we find it, 14 and 4. I need the room, so I'm going to erase all of this. 14 and 4, and we want to find the least common denominator, we multiply it by the least prime number that we can find as a common factor, which happens to be 2. This is 7 and this is 2, so 7 is a prime number, 2 is a prime number, the story ends because they have nothing in common. But as you can see, 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 7 is 28. 28 happens to be the least common multiplier, not 28 times 2. This would have been 28 times 2 because it's 14 times 4 as opposed to 14 times 2. So we want 28. How do we convert this into 28? It's very simple. Multiply it by 2 over 2. How do we convert this into 28? It's very simple. Multiply it by 7 over 7. And multiply this by 28 over 28. Voila. Let's pick up our speed. 2 times x is 2x. 2 times 3 is 6. I have to pay attention. This is where you're going to mess up if you don't pay attention. 7 times negative 2, this is important, it's negative 14, and this is simply 3 times 28, which I'm going to leave it as 3 times 28. I'm going to figure out what that is. We're going to figure out what that is if it's necessary. 2x and 21x is going to give us 23x, and negative 14 and 6 is going to give us negative 8. Negative 8. It looks like we do have to figure out what 28 times 3 is. 28 times 3 is going to be 75 plus 9, because 3 times 25 is 75, and 3 times 3 is 9. See, I broke up in my mind, I broke it up as 25 and a 3. 25 and a 3. And 3 times 25 is 75, and 3 times 3 is 9, and now we have to add 8 to both sides. So let's find out. Seventeen plus three would have been 20. One more time. 17 plus 5. I'm getting 22. 2, carry 2. Hope you can keep it separate. 7 plus 2 is 9. It's 92. I'm gonna erase all of the things because I just realized I turned it into a freak show. We could have kept it simple. I should have done it on the side here. So let's do it on the side here. 3 times 28 is what I was trying to figure out. 3 times 28, 28 times 3, which I broke it up into this part. 25 plus 3. 25 plus 3 is 28, and 25 times 3 is 75. 3 times 3 is 9, which gives us 84, and then we add 8 to it. 84 plus 10 would have been 94, therefore 84 plus 8 will be 92. So 23x equals 92, which means x equals 92 over 23. 92 over 23. How many 23 do you suppose 92 has? I'm going to erase all of this because it's getting in the way. How many 23 do you suppose 92 has? Well, 20 times 4, listen carefully, 20 times 4 is 80. So my guess is that it cannot be 5. I'll tell you why it cannot be 5. Look, it cannot be 5. Had it been 5, first of all, 20 times 5 is already more than 100, to say nothing of the fact that it is less than 100. But even if you didn't see that part, realize that if you were to multiply this quantity by 5, we'll end up with 3 times 5, which is 15. We'll end up with a unit digit of 5. We want a unit digit of 2, which means it must be 4. I shouldn't say it must be 4. Of course, the answer could turn out to be 4.5 or 4.75 or 4.37. But since we are preparing for standardized exams, any of these exams that you're preparing for, any of these tests that you're preparing for, GRE, GMAT, SAT, SAT, SE, these are all standardized exams. And in standardized exam, answer choice is not usually stupid answer choices. They don't just give you the answer choice, X being turned out to be 4.3785. It's not going to happen. Do you understand? Answer choices are laid out in front of you. You can clearly see by looking at the answer choices that they are all integers. They are all whole numbers. Since they are all integers, if it's not 5, it must be 4. Let's try it. As you can see, right away, you have a confirmation. We have a confirmation because 3 times 4 is 12. We wanted a unit digit of 2, we got a unit digit of 2. Carry 1, and 8 plus 1 is 9. X equals 4. Let's verify our answer, shall we? Don't create more work than is necessary. Look at the answer choices, and you can clearly see the answer choices are all integers. So it's got to be a whole number, obviously, the correct answer, because that's all they give you. It's not going to be 5, because 20 times 5 is already more than 100. We have only 92. It has to be 4. It's not going to be 3, because 3 is going to be too small. And you can immediately see that 4 times 3 is 12. It ends in a 2. If I were doing it myself, I wouldn't even do it out. It has to be 4. There is no other choice. X plus 3, X we are claiming to be 4, 4 plus 3 over 14 plus 3 times X, which is 4, plus, or rather minus 2 over 4. Let's see what happens. 4 plus 3 is 7, 7 divided by 14, we're going to end up with a half. Since we end up in a half, and this we know is 3, this better be 2.5. 12 minus 2 is going to be 10. 10 divided by 4, which is same as 5 over 2, which is same as 2.5. 2.5 plus a half is going to give us 3, which is exactly what the problem told us. Do you understand? It works. It verifies. Number 19. Question number 19. number 19. We are told 3 times x plus 7 over 11 minus x minus 9 over 5, we are told, equals x. Do it yourself, pause the video and do it yourself. What do you suppose the common denominator is going to be here? We have 11 and a 5, the least common multiplier is 55. Multiply both sides by 5, this side by 5 over 5, this term by 11 over 11, and this term right here by 55 over 55. Voila, we are done. So keep in mind that we have 3 times 5, which is 15, so we have 15 times x, which is 15x. And 15 times 7. 15 times 7. How much is 15 times 7? Oh, don't look at me. How the hell do I know? 15 times 7 is going to be 75, which is 5 15s, and 2 more 15s, which is 30. 105. I know 5 15s are 75. That I do know. 5 15s are 75. That I do know, because 10 15s are 150. That I do know. 10 15s. If you have 10 of them, 10 15s will make 150, because you just stick a 0 at the end. If 10 15s are 150, 5 15 must be half of it, which is 75. So I got my 5 15s. I need 2 more 15s, which is 30. If we add them up, what we'll end up is 7 15s. That's exactly what we need. 3 times 5 is 15, and we need 7 of them. Minus, keep in mind that it's minus now in front here. Minus 11 times x is going to be 11x. And a negative is going to give us a positive. 11 times 9 is going to be 99, and this is 55x. Let's see what we can do. 15x minus 11x is going to be 4x plus 105 plus 100. 105 plus 100 would have been 205, so this is 204. Subtract 4x from both sides. And 55 minus 1 is, minus 4 is 51. 51x equals 204. That's very straightforward. It's very straightforward because we know 50 times 4 is 200. 4 50s are 200 and 4 ones are 4, so it's 4. Let's verify it. Times x plus 7, 4 plus 7 over 11 minus x minus 9, which is 4, 4 minus 9 over 5. Let's see what it works out to be. 4 plus 7 is 11. 4 plus 7 is 11. We have 11 on the bottom, so that just drops out. We end up with 3 here. 3 minus 4 minus 9 is 5. 5 over 5 is 1, so it's 3 minus 1, which is 2. Which is not what x is. Something has gone wrong. Something has gone wrong. Did I make a mistake here? Where did I make a mistake? See, it does not confirm. What number are we at? X equals 4. 4 minus 5. Oh, 4 minus 5. You see, 4 minus 9 is a negative 1. It's going to be a negative 1, which is why it's important to pay attention. 4 minus 9 is going to be negative 5 over 5, which is going to give us 3. And negative 5 over 5 is going to be negative 1. Negative 1. 3 minus a negative 1 is going to be 4. It comes out to be 4, and which equals to x. Which equals to x, and which is exactly what we are told the other side was. We were told that this side, 3 times x plus 7 over 11 minus x minus 9 over 5 equals, we didn't have a numerical value, we were told it equals x, which is exactly what it is, because this quantity works out to be 4, and 4 is the value of x. It checks out. Number 20. I keep preaching over and over again to you to pay attention, and I myself keep mucking it up. Muck it up with an M, not an F. Number 20. number 20. Two x over 5 plus 3x over 6, we are told, equals 1 plus x minus 1. This is a tricky one. 1 plus x minus 1. 1 plus x minus 1. Let me rewrite this thing, x minus 1. So what's going to be the common denominator here? Well, the least common multiplier here of 5 and 6 is 30. So you want everything to be 30 at the bottom. How do we convert this 5 into a 30? It's very simple. Multiply it by 6 over 6. How do we convert this into a 30? Multiply it by 5 over 5. How do we convert this into 1 into a 30? Multiply it by 30 over 30. And this part has denominator of 1. We want 30, so it's 30 over 30. You with me? That's it, we're done. Now we need the room, so I'm going to erase the rest. Okay, here we go. I have to pay attention. 6 times 2 is 12, so it's 12x plus 3 times 5 is 15x. Equals 30, 3 times 1 is 30, plus, and this is where it's going to get tricky, 30 times x is 30x, and 30 times 1 is negative 30. Well, this is strange, this is peculiar. I have turned this problem into a veritable freak show. As you can see, this is since I started, I'm going to finish it. Since I began, I'm going to finish it. And we'll see what happens at the end, okay? Oh, I gave you the wrong problem. This is not what the problem was. I'm going to have to start again. No wonder this thing is not matching up in my work. This is not what the problem is. This thing is not going to work. Try it out. Do it out. Solve it yourself. Find the value of x. It might be a good idea to try it out and learn this way. Find the value of x. Try it out. And you'll see that whatever you find for the value of x, when you put it back in here, it's not going to work. Because the problem itself is wrong. Since we started it, I'm going to finish it. This is 17x. This is not 17x. This is 27x. And this is going to drop out, and this is 30x. The only way, I'm glad I did it because I didn't realize it was going to be that simple. The only way that 20x can be equal to 27x can be equal to 30x is when x is equal to 0. When x is equal to 0, it doesn't matter how many x's you have, 0 times 27 is 0, 30 times 27 is 0. But if you put the 0 back in here, it's not going to work. You can clearly see it's not going to work because this quantity is going to be 0. 2 times 0 is 0. This quantity is 0. This is 1. And this quantity is going to be 0 minus 1. 0 minus 1 is negative 1. 1. And 0 minus 1 is going to be negative 1. It does work. It does work actually. Just give me a second, okay? I'm not going to retape the whole thing because we have done too many problems here already. Does it work? The original problem was, this was the original problem. 2x minus 2x over 5 plus 3x over 6. I told you equals 1 plus x minus 1, and we are claiming that x is 0. So here we have 1 plus 0 minus 1 is negative 1, 1 plus 1 is 0, and this is also 0. So it does actually work. So it turns out that I made a mistake. I gave you the wrong equation, and it turns out actually it does work. But as you can see, it's not very interesting. There's not much there to do here. let me give you the proper equations because I made a mistake. We're going to start again. Let's call this 20A and we're going to do 20B. We're going to do 20B. This was 20A. Just leave it like this. We're going to do 20B, the proper equation. 2x over 5 plus 3x over 6. So you can see the mistake I made. This one is wrong. This one should have been a half. And you will see that it makes a world of difference now. It's an entirely different problem now. So, what do we do? And this one was 6 over 6, just so you know, 6 over 6. And I hope I did not make a mistake in the previous one itself. Yeah, see, the whole thing would have been quite stupid here, because as I look at it now, the way I wrote this thing, second part here, watch what happens. The way I wrote it was 1 plus x minus 1. That's a damn silly thing to say, because that's just x. Nobody's going to give you an equation like that. So if they tell you that some x is equals x, some x is plus some x is going to be some x is some quantity of x equals the x itself, the only way it's going to be true is when x is equal to 0. So that was a stupid question. You understand? I made a mistake. This is the actual question, and let's start again. Now here's what we're going to do. Notice what we have here. We have 3x over 6. We could leave it the way it is. Listen carefully. We could leave it the way it is. In which case, we'll have a common denominator of 30, just like before. We're going to have the common denominator of 30, and we're going to create a lot more work. What you have to do here is that if you find the fractions where we have a common factor between the numerator and denominator, anytime at all, when we're solving an equation, and you look at the different terms in the equation, and you find that some of the terms in the equations are presented to you in the form of a fraction, as they are here, ask yourself, is any of this fraction something that can be reduced? And if the answer is yes, if that fraction can be reduced, then do it right away. You will create a lot less work for yourself. You will cut down the amount of work that you will do by quite a lot. You understand? Here I see a 3 and I see a 6. I'm going to cut it down to half. So that makes life much easier. So now what we have is 2x plus 5 plus x over 2 equals 1 half plus x minus 1. So now we have a common denominator of 10, which is much better than 30. We have a common denominator of 10 multiplied by 2 over 2 multiplied by 5 over 5 multiplied by 5 over 5 and multiplied by 10 over 10. Two times x is 4x plus 5 times x is 5x equals 5 times 1 is 5 plus 10 times x is 10x. And pay attention, 10 times negative 1 is negative 10. This is going to give us 9x. This is going to give us 10x and minus 5. Subtract 9x from both sides. This is positive 9x. Subtract 9x from both sides and add 5 to both sides. This 9x are going to drop out. The 5 appears here. From there, this negative 5 appears here as positive 5. And 10x minus 9x is just an x, and 5 drops out, and x equals 5. All of a sudden, x equals 5, not 0, just because I forgot to put a 2 at the bottom. Now this is true, and we can verify it. We're going to verify it right here. Since I don't have the room, we're going to verify it right here. In place of x, we're going to put down 5. And watch what happens. So x equals 5, so here we have times 5 and 5. Watch what happens. 5's are going to drop out, and this is just 2, and we have 5 over 2, so it's 2 plus 5 over 2, 5 over, I'm going to do it here, I'm going to erase the second step here. So here we have 2 plus 5 over 2, 2 plus 5 over 2, 5 over 2 is 2.5, 5 over 2 is 2.5 plus 2 is 4.5, and here we have half, and 5 minus 1 is 4. As you can see, half plus a 4 is 4.5, and 2 plus 2.5 is also 4.5. It checks out. It checks out. The correct answer is 5. It is amazing, it is mind-boggling how much a problem can change just by one tiny slip. This is an entirely different animal than what we encountered there, just because I forgot to put a 2 at the bottom. Just because I forgot to put a 2 at the bottom. And if you forget to put the 2 at the bottom, this side was simply x, this side simply was 1 plus x minus 1. 1 will cancel out, and I caught myself there when I got a 30 here and 30 there. So 1 would crop out and we'll end up with just x, which means this side equals x on this version, 20a, and this side we have some x's. You see how I'm saying it's some x's. I don't know how many there are, I really don't care. Some x's, and here we have some more x's. Some x's plus some more x's, as long as they're not just one x, which it is not. 2 over 5 plus half, 2 over 5 plus half is not going to be 1. So we have some x's plus some other x's equals 1x. The only way some x's plus some other x's equals 1x is when x is 0. But that's a different animal than what we just did here. Now listen, my plan was to do 3 more problems, but I think I have taken way too much time. I'm not sure if I actually want to do 3 more problems. Should we do them? Let me take a look at the time in the clock here in the back. Just give me 1 second. Why not? Might as well. We are 37 minutes into it. 47, 50. Okay, let's do it. Let's do 3 more problems. Okay, quickly. This time I'm not going to mess it up. But sometimes you learn more by messing it up and by making a mistake. You learn how to catch your mistakes, and you learn to understand what went wrong. Simply saying that there's something went wrong and moving on and redoing it is not the idea. When you make a mistake, see if you can understand what went wrong, and see if you understand how it's turning out the way it did. It's very important. Number 21. We have x plus 3 over 9 plus x minus 5 over 5 equals, we are told, x minus 11. I want to make sure that I wrote the problem correctly. X plus 3 over 9 plus x minus 5 equals x minus 11. Notice how I left spaces there. So we're going to have a common denominator of 9 times 5, which is 45. We already have a 9 in the first term. Since we already have a 9 in the first term, we need to multiply it by 5 over 5. Voila, that part is done. Here we have a 5, let's multiply it by 9 over 9. Here we need to multiply it by 45 over 45. All done. 5 times x is 5x. 5 times 3 is 15. Here we have a positive, so you don't have to worry about anything. This is 9x. And 9 times 5, negative 5, is negative 45. And here we'll end up with 45 times x is 45x, and 45 times 11, keep in mind that it is negative first of all, 45 times 11 is just going to be 450 plus 45, which is 495. Notice how we did 45 times 11. I did 10 times 45, 10 45s are 450, and then another 45 is 495. Let's continue. So we have 5 plus 9, which is 14x, and 15 minus 45 is going to be negative 30, equals 45x minus 495. I'm going to erase this part now. Subtract 14x from both sides, and add 30 to both sides. Voila. Now if I add 30 to both sides, we're going to end up bringing everything there. We need to bring this 495 here. Add 495 to this side. Well, now the 495 goes away, and positive 14x and a negative 14x is going to go away. 495 minus 30 is going to be 465 equals 5 minus 4 is 1, and 4 minus 1 is 3. We end up with 31x. Now 31, listen carefully please, 31, I hope you're able to see right away that it's a prime number. It's a prime number, which means there are not going to be any common factor between these two at all. And it's a very large number, 465. So very first thing I'm going to do here, I'm going to take my 465 and subtract 310 from it, which is 10 of them. And when I do that, I'll end up with 155. Are you with me so far in this story? Now, second thing you have to understand is that because it ends in a 5, this is already 10. These are already 10 31s. But because the remainder here is 155, which ends in a 5, the only way, assuming that the answer choices are all numerical, integers, if you look at the answer choices and they're all integers, they're all whole numbers, then you know it's going to be a whole number. The only way it's going to end up in a 5, listen very carefully, the only way it's going to end up in a 5 is when x happens to be 5. This is already 10. This is the part we're talking about. So in other words, it's 15. You see, 31 times 3 is not going to end in a 5. 31 times 3 is going to end in a 3. 31 times 4 is going to end in a 4. We want it to end in a 5, which means it must be 5. It has to be 5. It is 15. x equals 15. And if you don't believe me, do it out and find it out yourself. This 13 times 5 is 155. We can do it right here. It has to be 31 times 5 has to be 165, because 30 times 5 is 150, and then 150, and then another 5, it's going to be 155. You see? 5 and then 15. So this represents 5 31s, and this represents 10 31, hence the 15 31. But what I'm trying to make you understand is that we don't have to do all of this thing. You have to simply realize it has to be 5 because of the fact that the unit digit is 5. 31 times 1 will end in a 1. 31 times 7 will end in a 7. Do you understand? I'm taking out 310. I already took them out. Do you understand? I'm talking about the last digit here. It has to be a 5. Let's verify our answer. We're claiming that the answer is 15. X plus 3, 15 plus 3 over 9, plus X minus 5, which is 15 minus 5 over 5. Let's see what this works out to be. 15 plus 3 is 18, 18 divided by 9, 18 over 9, which is a 2, plus 15 minus 5 is 10, 10 divided by 5, which is also a 2, which gives us 4. And 4, what do you suppose 4 equals to? 4 happens to equal to 15 minus 11. And 15 minus 11, 15 is what we are saying x is, so it happens to be x minus 11, which is exactly what the other side was. Which is exactly what the other x minus 11. It confirms. Number 22, the penultimate one. Penultimate one, 22. We learned about penultimate in our vocabulary lessons, and I use it so often, as a matter of fact, every time we get to the second last question, I say the penultimate one. I use it so often that I even remember that it was day number 11, as far as I can remember, that is. Just type in vocabulary words, day 11, and you will learn the word penultimate, which is a very fancy way of saying second to the last, because we are going to do 23 of them. We are at 22. Why 23? Why not 25? Why not 20? I don't know. Just because. So here we have 4/3 x plus 5. Plus 5/2 x minus 2 equals 5x minus 3. 5x minus 3. One more time. We are told that 4/3. See, now this coefficient here begins to appear in fraction form. 4/3 x plus 5 plus 5/2 x minus 2 equals, we are told on this side, 5x minus 3. Let's see what we can do. We want the common denominator, we want the least common multiplier. Least common multiplier of 3 and 2 is going to be 6. So we multiply both this side, the first term, by 2 over 2 to make it a 6. Multiply this by 3 over 3, make it a 6. And multiply this guy by 6 over 6. Well, we are done. Now we can do our show. Okay, let's get going. So here we have 2 times 4, which is 8. 8 times x is 8x. 8 times 5 is 40. Plus 3 times 5 is 15. 15 times x is 15x. And 15 times negative 2 is going to be negative 30. And here we have 6 times 5, which is 30x. And 6 times 3 is going to be negative 18. Pay very close attention, because like I said, if you're going to make a mistake, this is where, this is the place where people mess up very often, that is. 8 plus 15, 15 plus 10 is 25, so it's going to be 23. 23x, and then 4d minus the 30 is going to be 10, equals 30x minus 18. Let's subtract 23x from both sides. And let's bring 18 to this side. 23x are going to drop out. We end up with 28x equals 30 minus 23 is going to be 7x. This is going to drop. 7x equals 28x. 7x equals 28, which makes it very simple. X must be 4. X would have to be 4. X equals 4 because 4 times 7 is 28. Let's verify, shall we? Let's verify it. 4/3, x plus 5, x we're claiming to be 4, 4 plus 5, plus 5/2, x minus 2, 4 minus 2. 4 plus, I'm not going to actually do out every single baby step, I'm just going to make it simpler. So pay attention, 4 plus 5 is 9, 9 divided by 3 is 3. So this is going to drop out and this becomes 3, we end up with 12. This 2 right here is 4 minus 2 is 2 and it just drops out and we end up with 5. We end up with 17 on this side. 17 on this side. Let's see what we end up on the other side. On the other side we have 5x minus 3. That is what was given to us. 5x minus 3. And we are claiming that x is 4. 5 times 4 minus 3 is 20 minus 3, which is exactly 17. It checks out. 5 times 4 minus 3 is 17, which is exactly what we found on the left-hand side. Left-hand side equals right-hand side, which means our answer was correct. Our work was indeed proper. 23. Last one. Another one with the fraction. Oh, lost it. 3/4 x plus 1 plus 3/2 x minus 1 minus 4/5 x plus 3 equals x plus 4. So I had to put it in two lines because I don't want to crowd everything. I'm going to erase everything else. This is the very last one. I want you to do it yourself. I want you to pause the video and do it yourself right now. I'm going to read to you one more time. I'm going to read it to you one more time. And that's not a 3/4. That's a 5 over 4. 5/4. It's a good thing I caught myself. 5/4 plus 5/4 times x plus 1 plus 3/2 times x minus 1 minus 4/5 times x plus 3, we are told equals x plus 4. Do it yourself, okay? The very first thing you have to figure out is the least common multiplier. Least common multiplier of 4, 2, and 5. 4, 2, and 5. Divided by of common factor of 2. 4 divided by 2 is 2, and this becomes 1, and this becomes 5. We cannot go anymore because 2 is a prime number, 5 is a prime, it ends. So it's 2 times 2, which is 4. 4 times 5 is 20. 20 is the least common multiplier. 20 is the least common multiplier. Keep in mind that this is the right-hand side of the equation. All of this is the left-hand side of the equation. We want the common denominator to be 20. So let's begin. How do we convert this into 20? Multiply it by 5 over 5. How do we convert this into 20? Multiply it by 10 over 10. How do we convert this into 20? Multiply it by 4 over 4. How do we convert this denominator 1 into a 20? Multiply it by 20 over 20. Voila, it's done. It's done. Let's begin, shall we? Let's begin. So here we're going to get 5 times 5 times x, which is 25x. And 25 times 1 is going to be 25, plus 10 times 3 is 30, 30 times x is 30x, 30 times negative 1 is going to be negative 30, 4 times 4 is 16, but keep in mind it's negative 16, times x is going to be negative 16x, and 4 times 3 is 48, but it's a negative, so it's minus 48, and on this side, on that side, we find, let's line them up so that everything lines up properly, on this side we find 20 times x is 20x, and 20 times 4 is 80. Let's combine the like terms, shall we? Let's combine the like terms. We get, watch what happens here. You can do it any way you want. You can do it any way you want. There is no right or wrong way of doing it. Just do any way you like. Instead of adding all three numbers together, the 25 and the 30 and the 16, instead of adding all three of them together, I'm going to do baby step. I'm going to do two at a time. Negative 16 and a 30 is going to give us positive 14. I hope you are able to see that. It's going to give us positive 14. And now I can do the rest. 20 plus 10 is 30. 30 plus 9 is 39. So here we end up with 39x. And again, you see, I see a positive 25. I see a negative 5. I'm going to drop them out, and this becomes negative 5. Negative 5 and a negative 48 is going to give us negative 53. Why don't I write it right here? 39x. Minus negative 53. There you go. And that equals the other side. Add 53 to both sides. Keep your fingers crossed because it's very easy to mess it up. I hope I did not mess up already. This is going to drop out. And we need to bring 20 to this side. We're going to end up 19x equals, this is going to drop out, and this is 3 and 13. Again, as you can see, 19 is a prime number. 19 is a prime number, which means there is no common factor here. How many 19s will make 133? Pay very close attention, okay? Very close attention. 19, how many 19s make 33? That's what we're trying to figure out. Always keep in mind, as you look at the answer choices, you will see that they are all integers. As I keep reminding you, as I keep repeating like a parrot, since all the answer choices are integers, you know it has to be a whole number, whatever it is. How many 19s make 133? Well, we know, pay very close attention, we know 20 times 6 is 120. If 20 times 6 is 120, and since we don't have 20, we have only 19, and this is not 120, this is 133, this is more than 120, and there's only 19 of them, which means it must be 7. How else do we know? Well, try it out. I shouldn't say it must be 7. Let's try it out. How can we confirm it? It's very simple. It's very, very simple. It has to be 7. Because 9 sevens are, how much are 9 sevens? I know 10 sevens. 10 sevens, I know if I have 10 of the sevens, I have 70. 10 sevens are 70. And therefore, if you take away 1 seven from those 10 sevens, then what we will be left with are 9 sevens. And 9 sevens are 63. Because 63 happens to be equal to 70 minus 7. 63 ends in a, believe it or not, 3. Which is exactly what we are looking for here. The unit digit is 3. It is 7. X equals to 7. But if you want to finish it up. So it's 63, 3 carries 6, 7 plus 3 is 13, and there you go. X equals to 7. Let's verify, shall we? We need the room to verify it. Just give me 1 second here before I erase things. We're going to verify it right here. 5/4 x plus 1, x we're claiming is 7. I'm just going to put down 8 here. X plus 1 is 8. 3/2, x minus 1, 7 minus 1 is 6. minus 5 4/5 x plus 3, x is 7, so it's 10. And that's the 5. You with me? Watch what happens. Watch what happens. We have a 4 and we have an 8. 4 is going to drop out and this 8 is going to become 2. We have a 6 and a 3 is 2. This is going to drop out, it becomes 3. 5 is going to drop out and 10 will become 2. Not 5. 10 will become 2. And let's see what we get on the left hand side. Oh, I need more room. We need a lot more room. So we end up with 5 times 2 is 10, plus 3 times 3 is 9, minus, it's very important that we pay attention, minus 4 times 2, which is 8. So 9 minus 8 is 1, so it's 11. It's 11. Now let's see what the other side works out to be. The other side is right here, 20x plus 80. 20x plus 80, which is not going to work out what we need. That's not what the other side was. The other side was this part, 4/5 x plus 3. I need the room, so we're going to have to raise this. The other side was, that this is the right-hand side. The right-hand side was 4/5 plus x plus 3. 4/5, x we are claiming to be, what was x? X must have been 7. X must have been 7 because we have 8 written here. 7 plus 1 is 8. It must have been 7. 7 minus 1 is 6. It was 7. So here we have 7 plus 3. 7 plus 3, 7 plus 3 is 10. 10 divided by 5 is 2. And 4 times 2 is 8. Oh, what the hell? 9 minus 8 is 1, 11. I'm getting 8. 10 plus 9 minus 8 is 11. And here we have 4/5. I can't believe I made a mistake at the very end. 4/5. Oh, was it just 4/5? Oh, that is not the second side. That is not the right hand side. That is not the right hand side. Oh my God, I can't believe this is wrong. That's not the right-hand side, which is why it's not working out. The right-hand side was simply x plus 4. Was simply x plus 4. Right-hand side was simply x plus 4, and x we are claiming to be 8. X we are claiming to be 7. 7 plus 1 is 8. So it's 7 plus 4, which is 11, which is 11, which is what we have here. This video is getting to be too long, you see? That was it. Bye now.